Good evening, guys, and welcome back to my channel. I was working in my little blue journal when I realized that I might as well put on the camera so you can see what I'm up to today. So here I am with my little blue one, and I have started putting in ephemera and laces, made some pockets and some tabs, small flips. So this is where I am at the moment, filling up with the different kind of things. It starts getting a little bit thick, but I still think we can put a few beautiful things in it. So at the moment I'm putting in laces, and this is the front decoration, or the cover decoration, that I'm putting together, kind of something like this, that will go on the front with just a closure band of some kind. So I'm not going to glue it on. I wanted to be removable, so you can choose if you just want your book like this or if you want the decoration to go on top of it. So this will be put together some way. This is an old envelope, so it will be possible to put something in it as a pocket, and then we are going to have this little pocket flip down here to keep this together, so something can pick out in the envelope too. But that will need to have some laces and textile too, so I have left it for the moment. So let's continue to put on some beautiful laces. I think this one will need something on the back. So I have taken a few of my laces to use and put in. So let's see what we can find. And a bit more straight. So I'm thinking we can put this halfway down on the page, then we can use this part as a little pocket, and then use this as decoration peeking down. So let's put glue on these three sides so we can make a pocket. That's nice. Then we can just use this as an extra pocket down here. So this little house might need something also. Should we maybe go with this little thin lace? I think that could work. I don't want it to be too bulky. I am trying to keep it closable. And then just cutting off the excess. That works nicely. So this page has already got a little green one. Should we maybe put on one of these? This has a little label on it. I have colored it all with the label and everything on top. So let me just take out this. And then see if this holds it in place. Yes, it has glued itself down. So then let's leave that cute little label. Might need to do like this so we can see the crocheted piece. That's better with some more decoration. Just making sure that this will be glued down properly. Moving on to the next page. So, should we put in a little textile embroidery pocket on this side? And I'm using my bookbinding glue as always, so this won't move a bit when it has dried. I'm leaving it to hang down a little bit so we get that cute decoration. You can fray it a little bit more, so making sure that the top piece is glued down properly. This is from an embroidered old pillowcase. I guess it's made in the beginning of 1900, or maybe even the end of 1800. This is from a wedding sheet they embroidered for the wedding night. So this is a neighbor to me that I have purchased this from. So this is her grandmother's initials. Her name was Elin, and it's actually the same that my grandma also had. Her name was also Elin. So I thought that could be nice with a little E. Cute boys has a pocket on this one, and we have a side pocket on this one with some embossed paper with roses. This is just a decoration, so I'm thinking that we can put another one up here. A little bluish on the back, so you can use this light blue one. It's also thin, so it won't be so thick to put in. Was a bit short. I think we can take the blue one here too. I want this thin one, so I'm thinking decoration and a bit of a flip. Let's to put it so it won't be in the way when we open it. So that this can work. Secure it with some more glue on the edges. That's nice. So one more down here maybe. We'll go with this old antique blue one. Okay, this I think we can call this almost done. Now we just need to put in some more inserts and small details, I think. So we don't overdo it and can't be able to close it. Nice with that blue and the blue on the page. Yes, I like that. So I will just clean out of my table and find my labels and small things to decorate with, so I will be back in a second. So I have got all of my, not all of my, but a lot of my small pieces for decoration. And I have also sewn or put this together. With some laces, and then we have the envelope here, so we can still put something in that one, and you can pull these and these out so they are loose. You can use the envelope, and it's put together with a paper clip, and that will go on top of the journal, and then we will have a seam binding going around it. So I think that will be cute. So let's go back and see if we can decorate some more. Maybe something on this side. little label on top of that. A bit of blue on it. And a couple of roses, I think. To finish it off. So now we have another little tuck spot here to put something in. And that page, I think, will be done. This one will need another one. That's cute. I'm going to take a piece of paper that is a bit sturdier, so this can be a pocket. So let's just take another piece of paper. So we make sure that it won't rip. Tone the white edges down with some antique linen distress ink. Or actually this is distress oxide. I'm using this mostly, but they were out of this ink, so I had to take the oxide. But I think we will survive that too. This is a bit fragile. I just want to make sure that it will hold, as we want to use it as a pocket. Give this one a little blue rose too. They are so cute. Makes such a big difference when you just have these blue roses. I think it's a bit nice to have a brown label that says blue. It's a bit fun. going for some packaging paper. I got a delivery with some new embossing folders and some glue. So now I have a lot of nice brown paper again. Crumble that corner a bit. Let's take a Tim Holtz pocket. Some layering. And this one on top of that. I guess we can fill this up with something fun later. When we do the final touches. And I think I will leave this. I have a few more things I want to put in. So I'm thinking I am leaving that as it is for now. And this can get some layering. A little detail. A little blue detail up in the corner can make a big difference. This one will also have another decoration, so I'm leaving that too. And I'm thinking this can have a little number. I love this page with the small pieces of fern and the blue dots. So I think I can't do something on that page. I need to leave it as it is and just put in something, a photo or something, in the pocket instead. Isn't that beautiful, that pattern? Looks almost like blueberries. Original eco dyeing, really nice. And those are okay. can tuck something inside that frame later on. And those will be left. A little ruffle. Building up a little tuck spot down in this corner. Taking vintage photo and darken this a little bit more. Just so it will go with the roses. Need balance. And a couple of brown roses. I need to make this red stripe disappear. I can't stand red in a blue journal. Sorry. That. Going for a piece of lace. Another Sam Poole stamp. I love to work with these labels and just get these small details that can make such a big difference. It's hard to get these to stick on top of the lace, but I think we will manage. a piece of embossed paper. And a little tuck spot in the corner. This is a piece of textile I have stamped on. The last one. I need to put down this beautiful piece with a little stamp on it. Maybe we should have put a frame around that. That can peek out. Then we can just glue this part down and use it as a tuck spot too. Then we can kind of tuck something behind it if we would love to. Okay, guys, I think this will be it for tonight. I hope you got some idea and like my little journal. It's kind of getting there. with all the lace and the small pieces of lace peeking out here and there. So soon this will be done, I think. We need to put a few more pictures and old papers in it. But I kind of like it. And as I love blue, this is really my color. So yes, it's coming on really nice. I like this page where all the laces is hanging down like that. And then the boys. So cute. Really love that. Okay, guys. Thank you for watching, and I will be back soon again and work with some more of my journals. So if you like this, please give me a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, I would really appreciate your subscription. And hit the notification bell so you can get an announcement when I'm doing my next journal. Until next time, bye bye from Sweden.